CT Mac here again with another Planet Explorers video, and today we're actually playing the Alpha 0.53. So this update's been out for quite a few days now, I just haven't got around to playing it.
Yeah.
As you can see, we've taken on a quest called Monster Hunter 1. This quest is from the same base that we had in the previous video. You'll see when I get back there that the base is actually a lot better than originally. And they have renamed some of the NPCs in that base. This is a quest I expected to be defend the lady while she does her experiment again. But it wasn't. It was Monster Hunter 1. So, one of the updates is mobs run away. It's very frustrating. Luckily for me, some of these mobs are quite slow. Other mobs, like these, are a lot faster. And can be a lot harder to chase. Oh, come on. Almost one-shotted you. Almost one-shotted you. Come here, you little bugger. He's gonna run right into them. And if they get the kill shot, I don't know if it counts towards my quest. I'm probably getting myself into a bit of danger here. Oh, and I'm going to die. Well now. Oh, I have to use an item to revive my character now. It's interesting. I'm also 5 out of 6. On the quest. Okay, well, this guy doesn't want to die. Oh, wrong button. Can I out bosh him? Can I even bosh him? There we go. Okay, so the combat could still use a bit of work. My apologies if that failure in combat is just my failure to play this game. Oh, look, there's a small one there. Might be able to one-shot him. Oh, really? And you're just going to run towards those things, are you? Come on, kill it. And thank you. That's quest done. Done and dusted. So for future reference, other enemy kills on your quest mobs do, at the moment, count towards your quest completion. So, as you can see, the base has better fortifications, hopefully. And you can actually, I'll show you. If we run up to this guy, Nora has vanished. It is now Stephen and Gloria, I think. So if we say why not work together, and you see down here, he is my follower, my NPC follower, and you can click on him. You can see all of his equipment, give him new stuff, give him items, and yeah, he is a herb gatherer. I'm not entirely sure how that is going to help, but it might. Where are these 15 herb juices? Oh, there we go. Okay, we need to eat some food because we are running out of stamina. Let's see if this doctor has got anything that replenishes stamina. Okay. How much meat do we have? Well, we can buy one. Let's buy one for now and consume the biscuits and then use one of these, gain some health, and let's do the next quest. I'm going to try an experiment, but it might attract some wild animals here. Do you think you can help me defend this spot? I'll give you hunter clothing script in return. Okay. So, as you can see, this quest has been fixed, hopefully. The preparation time looks a lot better. The font in this whole entire game has improved quite a lot for this update. And we now have a start bar. So, let's go ahead and click that. And get ready to die. Okay, stuff is being boshed. That's what I like to see. So far, so good. Although, we might have a problem on our hands here. They have entered the fortification. And this guy, the NPCs now have weapons, so they no longer use their fists to boss. Oh, but they do get thrown around in the air. Oh, my follower seems to be using his fists, but the doctor and the quest giver are actually a lot better prepared for this. Okay, I'm going to go around and loot, because meat is money. And animal fat is campfires and torches. Okay, you're dead. Bit of fruit. Oh, this wall has been boshed. Tell me this little guy didn't bosh the wall. Oh, there's a stag. And look at that. The flying mob was destroyed by turrets. Okay. You need to die because he's boshing down the walls with my turrets. So, if I can say that I've learnt anything from this, that is put walls in front of turrets. Because if they bosh the wall underneath your turret, your turret is no longer usable. So I'll get back to repairing that later, I think. What I'm going to do now is use this script, use another one of these, and check out. Where is it? Hunter clothing. We need animal skin. Okay. Okay. Animal fat. Can I remove this? Get. Oh, look at that. This game has seen a very good update. Sorry, I'm half distracted here. Okay, so now it's time for you to see. Free build mode. This has made building this base so much better. So we shift and we should be able to go up. Bosh. Click and drag. Bosh. So, this is very much like the option in the game that allows you to make your own weapons and vehicles. Sorry, I was a bit lost for words there, but it's okay. We didn't recover very nicely, but we recovered. So not that I think it matters at the moment, but that might be okay. I will post some videos of the item creation mode. I'll quickly show you that. This is full customization. You can make swords, guns, small vehicles, and large vehicles. And this is what I've created so far. It is unfinished, but it is a work in progress. I'm quite looking forward to getting this in-game and using it, because I'm quite sick of using a stone sword. But enough for that for now. Let's get back to the game. Okay, so what was we looking for? We were looking for animal skin to be able to make some clothing. Let's speak with Gloria. I'm going to try and experiment. Okay, so seems to me like maybe that is where her quests finish. That's alright. That is perfectly fine. Because what I shall do... Oh. The rotation feature seems to have disappeared. Again, nothing too severe. Let's put one there. Okay, let's do this quest one more time. Considering last time we didn't get any massive boshy things that like to come and destroy all my hard work and all the NPCs.
Yeah! 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 Yeah!
Right, yeah. Come on.
Yeah.
You're going down, buddy.
Yeah.
And you're going down as well, and then you're both going to give me some animal skin. Animal fat. Animal fat. Okay. I think there's going to be a big thing. Well, that's not the big thing, but it does breathe fireballs, and it does bosh and one shot. And it charges. So if I can just distract it here for a bit. My stuff should, I would hope, be able to... This is not good. This is not good at all. I'm missing turrets. And this thing is boshing me by stumping on the ground. Oh, go away. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Okay, loot, 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 loot. Okay, quick, loot. Okay, let's just take a bit of damage and get him done quick. Please don't one-shot me. Oh, thank you. Animal bone and meat. Okay, so we're missing a wall over here. NPC's going to die. I'm going to try and save her. Because I'm pretty sure we don't want to fail the quest. I'm not sure if we can by her dying, but let's just not have to deal with that.
Yeah.
Come on, if we all band together. Thank you. Okay, no animal skin yet. Right, righty-ho. Let's go back into this mode and repair this wall. Nice and quick. Okay, so we need more turrets, we need more wood for turrets, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to speak to this guy. I'm going to free him. And then I'm going to speak to him, and I'm going to see what quest he has for us. Woodhill script. Hello, Stephen. I'm going to try an experiment. Oh, you too. Really? Really? You too? Oh, this is not what I expected. Well, at least we know that we can do this. So, my apologies. We're not dying, so it might make a little bit more interesting viewing. Let's get enough for a couple. And what we'll do is we'll do this quest and then we'll go find another NPC and we'll see what he has for us to do. Okay, so we can make 5 more. Let's just make 5. Bish bosh bang. Okay, so this didn't work out quite as expected, but that's good. Part of the learning process. What I'll do is I'll place a turret in midair. Bosh that one. Okay, so we got 3 there. 3 there. Okay, so really it was that big thing that could have thrown fireballs at us but didn't. That was the problem. So let's now go and place some turrets. That to me looks like it might be a good idea up there. Let's place a turret up here. Let's place a turret on here. Let's place a turret there, and we shall place a turret over here. Okay, let's go. Let's do it. Oh, and there comes a flying one. That flying one only came because I have a turret in the air. You know that is the case. Well, it's doing pretty good. Although one turret's been demolished pretty quick. Oh, my God. I should really wall off this little bit. I mean, to get that little thing, he does a lot of damage throwing his rocks. It seems to have high defense or a lot of HP. Can I loot you, please? No? Okay. You're botching my stuff, dude. You gotta stop. Animal skin, score. Okay, they're distracted boshing on walls. So, as long as there's no flying things, having walls around turrets in midair is a good idea. Okay, quest done. So, I'm going to loot this body over here, and then I'm going to show you something. If any of you are wondering, that light coming from my head here, which you can see, is what I believe to be a new addition to 0.53. Back at the original NPC, where I looted the storage chest that was in the dirt, it was in there. So it's much better than the torch, much better. Still can't really say it's that helpful at night time, because you still can't see anything. Apparently the day-night cycle has been fixed, so you no longer have 1 hour days and then 2 hour nights. I know it's a bit of an exaggeration, but it felt like it. So if you could see, I've already wandered over here once. I'm going to fast travel for one meet, just so you don't have to watch me. And we're going to see what this guy has to offer. I believe he is the weaponsmith. So, where are you, buddy? You're right behind me, having a leisurely rest.
Oh.
Shenzhen. Let's see what he's got for sale. Ooh. This... Oh, now this is what I am talking about. Okay, so... We're going to see what the first quest is. Trying to build a catapult template, but I need some materials. Can you go find them for me? Okay. So, we'll go find these materials. Stone and wood. Once I've found the materials, I am going to call this episode quits and get right started on the next episode. I think we're finally falling into place. Hopefully this won't take too long. They seem to have upped the amount of wood you receive from chopping trees, although they have also upped the amount of time it takes to chop trees. I think it's a fair trade. So as you can see as well, the digging, they've put the like a little indicator on whereabouts you will actually be digging. It is quite helpful. It has also smoothed the digging process, so you can be a little bit more precise. Let's see, can I dig this for stone? I can certainly dig it, but I'm not receiving anything. So can I dig this? And not receiving anything. So... maybe if I go into the crater, looks like should be some stone. Maybe I have to create a pickaxe. Wooden pickaxe. 10. That'll leave me 16. Need more. Okay, wood's easier to get. Wood is easier to get. So, let's equip that quickly. And let's mine some stone, hopefully. Okay, that's limestone. Ah, all of this is limestone. Just my luck. Okay, let's quickly go and replace that wood. Just to be able to get one hassle out of the way. Chop in, chop, 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 chop in. Okay, this tree is taking a lot of chopping. 32 wood. OMG, right? Wow. Okay, let's dig here, because under dirt is usually stone. And bosh. No dirt, just stone. So, let's go back, hand this quest in. Hello, buddy.
Hey there.
I have finished what you told me to do. Now I can finish this work of art. Look at this. What did you give me? A catapult script. And what do we need to make a catapult? Stone and wood. Okay, so... I'm going to call it quits there. Next episode is going to be in-depth weapon specialist quests, and I'm going to purchase some better weapons. So, thanks for watching, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you again next time. Bye!